We're 900 meters away from fiber internet.
David Yeaman's plastic mold injection business is just rural enough that high-speed internet is out of reach. Now, that's holding him back.
It's changed tremendously because software in the cloud didn't exist 13 years ago when we first moved in here.
He's limited to a slow wireless connection over satellite. Uploading and sharing a single plastic mold design can take 4 or 5 hours.
To put that in perspective, if we were in the city of Barrie, that would take 20 minutes.
Yeaman's worried that if Bell cuts back on its plan to expand rural internet access, it will slow down his shot at a better connection. But Bell says it has its own problems. The CRTC, the country's telecom regulator, ordered internet providers like Bell to lower wholesale prices permanently, in some cases by more than 75%, and it applies retroactively. Bell says it'll cost them $100 million, so it's cutting its rural expansion by 20% to help come up with the money.
In effect, what we're seeing is a temper tantrum, that they are going to withhold connectivity to rural Canadians until, I don't know what happens, their profits return.
For independent internet providers like TechSavvy, it's a big win.
We'll be able to make much more confident decisions going forward, not only for investments, but also for pricing for our customers.
But rural Canadians likely don't have access to those smaller independent providers, so that doesn't help them either. Yeaman says Bell and Rogers have told him he can get fiber installed if he pays for it, between $300,000 and $400,000.
We have to figure out whether we have to invest that much money in the infrastructure ourselves, which clearly we can't afford, and or we have to move out of the area.
The need is undeniable, yet a solution now seems even further down the road. Jacqueline Hansen, CBC News, Oromandante, Ontario.